I want to ask you what the past year in command in Iraq has taught you about counterinsurgency and what, if anything, that has taught you in turn about the limits of American power.
I don't want to pat myself on the back, or really, it was not me anyway. It was a team, huge team effort. But I think that what it has done is validated a lot of the changes that the military services have made, and in particular, obviously, the Marines and the Army. In terms of what sometimes are referred to as the engines of change for the institution. It's about institutional learning and adaptation. And obviously it starts with big ideas, in this case in the military, for the Marine Corps, for the Army, for all the services. It's our doctrinal manuals. They're the underpinning and the intellectual foundation. And of course you have the counterinsurgency field manual for the Army and the Marine Corps. They also had more recently the concept of full spectrum operations sort of reaffirmed, which we had before.
In 3-1, right.
But I mean, I think that, and then you have to then, in a sense, educate the leaders on those big ideas. And you do that at the commission, non-commission, and warrant officer education in those systems that we have, which include basic courses, career courses, staff colleges, and then sergeant's major academy or college and all the rest of that. And then you have to apply it, and you apply it with units at the combat training centers, national training center, joint readiness training center, joint multinational readiness center in Germany, 29 palms for the Marines, red flag or actually for the Air Force and all the rest. So, and of course you do it in actual contingency operations, the actual conduct of operations in Iraq, Afghanistan, and so forth. And you then have to have a feedback mechanism, which is in the Army's case, it's the Center for Army Lessons Learned, the Asymmetric Warfare Group, you have the Joint Lessons Learned Center at Norfolk, Corps has a Lessons Learned Center, all the services do. And that provides feedback to refine the big ideas, to refine, to adjust the instruction, if you will, the education of our curriculum for our leaders, to make changes to the scenarios that are carried out in the combat training center, which of course evolve from being in combat collision with the tank armies in the border with California in the Mojave Desert, to now sort of continuous counterinsurgency operations with hundreds of Iraqi native speakers and over 1,000 other role players, try to replicate everything that you find in Iraq or in Afghanistan, there's a mountain scenario, or wherever else it might be going. We've adjusted also the preparation for all of our units, the road to deployment. And I guess the big conclusion is that I think that we have made a number of very important changes that have, over time, captured the accumulation of lessons learned in Iraq and Afghanistan, the Philippines, and so forth, and that our leaders in Iraq and Afghanistan, or in particular in Iraq, because I know that here, and I believe it's true, that our leaders and our troopers have a better understanding of what it is we're doing, the culture in which we're doing it, the people who are the decisive terrain. Big idea number one is you have to secure and serve the population. To do that, you have to live among them, and so forth and so on. But that, in general, we've made a lot of constructive changes. And again, no means just Petraeus and Mattis and Nagel and Monster and a couple of the other survey department masters and
mm-hmm.
It's the institution.